Hello viewers, in today's session we are going to discuss another differential equation containing the famous Dirac delta function, right? So here we have to solve this initial value problem in which we are given this differential equation, that is y prime is equal to delta of t minus 2 pi with the conditions y of 0 is equal to pi. Right. So in this session, we'll see how we can solve the differential equations involving the Dirac delta function and with the initial conditions. Right. So here I will make the method of make use of the method of Laplace transforms, and then we'll use some standard results from inverse Laplace transform. Right. So let us see how we can solve these kind of differential equations. So here we are given y prime is equal to delta of t minus 2 pi, which can also be written like this. Right. Y prime of t is equal to delta of t minus 2 pi. Right, where y prime of t is the derivative of y of t with respect to t. So now let us take the Laplace transform of both sides, right? So we have L of y prime of t is equal to L of delta of t minus 2 pi, right? Now to find out the Laplace transform of derivative of a function, we can use this result, that is the Laplace transform of f prime of t is given by s times f of s, where f of s is the Laplace transform of the function f of t, right? So here the notations are important, and s times f of s minus f of 0, right? Where f of 0 is the value of the function at t is equal to 0. So here we are using the capital F for this function, or we can also replace this f of t, that is small f, by capital F, right? So this is the formula for the Laplace transform of f prime of t, which is s times f of s minus f of 0. Right, so here L of y prime of t can be written as s times the Laplace transform of y of t. So here we can write y of s minus y of 0. Right, so using this result, we can write the Laplace transform of y prime of t s times y of s, where y of s is the Laplace transform of y of t, right? And here the Laplace transform of this delta function may be written as e raised to minus 2 pi s, because we know that the Laplace transform of the delta of t minus a is given by e raised to minus a s, right? So now we have this equation. Now y of 0 is given as pi, so we can now write s y of s minus pi is equal to e raised to minus 2 pi s. Now taking minus f minus pi to this side, we can write y times y of s is equal to pi plus e raised to minus 2 pi s. So now let us write y of s is equal to pi over s, dividing these two terms by s. We have e raised to minus 2 pi s over s, right? Now y of s is equal to the Laplace transform of the function y of t. So here we can write L of y of t, right? So now to get the value of the function y of t, which is our objective to solve this differential equation, because when we solve a differential equation, our aim is to find out the function. So here we have y of t. So y of t can be written as the inverse Laplace transform of this function, that is pi over s plus e raised to minus 2 pi s over s. So now the inverse Laplace transform follows the linearity property. So we can now write L inverse, and here we have pi over s, then we have L inverse, and here we have e raised to minus 2 pi s over s, right? Now here we can take this pi outside. So we have pi, and then we have L inverse of 1 over s, and here we have L inverse, and we can write it as e raised to minus 2 pi s times 1 over s, right? So now our function y of t can be given by this equation number 2. So now here I will make use of two important results from the inverse Laplace transform, right? See, we know that the Laplace transform of 1 is equal to 1 over s, right? And we can now write the inverse Laplace transform of 1 over s as 1, right? So here we have 1, so we can now write y of t is equal to pi times 1, and to get the value of this expression, will again make use of an important result from inverse Laplace transform, that is L inverse of e raised to minus as, and here we have, say, f of s is given by f of t minus a times h of t minus a, right? This is an important result. So the inverse Laplace transform of this function, that is e raised to minus as fs, is equal to f of t minus a times the Heaviside unit step function h of t minus a, where f of s is the Laplace transform of the function f of t, right? So here we have f of t. So now here we have L inverse of e raised to minus 2 pi s times 1 over s. So comparing this expression with this one, the value of a is 2 pi, right? The value of a is 2 pi, and f of s is given by 1 over s, right? So here f of s is 1 over s. So it implies that L of f of t is given by 1 over s. So from this result, we can easily see that the value of this function f of t is equal to 1, right? So f of t is equal to 1 because the Laplace transform of 1 is 1 over s, right? So now using this result, we can write the value of this inverse Laplace transform as f of, so we have f of t minus a, a is 2 pi, and here we have h of t minus 2 pi, right? Now f of t minus 2 pi can be obtained from this function. So here we have f of t is equal to 1, so f of t minus 2 pi is equal to 1, because here f of t is independent of t, right? So now we have y of t is equal to pi, and then we have here 1 times h of t minus 2 pi, where h is the Heaviside unit step function. So now we can write y of t is equal to pi plus h times t minus 2 pi, right? So viewers, this is the solution of this differential equation.